Welcome to this video. In this video, I would like to show you how you can quickly find the table of an input field with the F1 help in SAP ERP and SAP S4HANA. Enjoy this video and let's get started. So here we are right now in a transaction code VA03 to display sales document. And for example, we would like to know what kind of table is in use for this input field for the sales order number. So in here we set the focus into this input field by clicking into this input field and then we hit the F1 key on our keyboard. After hitting the F1 key, then the performance assistant will open up and here we will see a nice description of this input field. In this bar there we have other useful buttons and functionalities available and we are interested in the technical information button. So we click on this button and down here we see the pop-up technical information. And here under the area field data, there we see the table name VBAK. So once we've select this, then use Control C to copy it. And then with the button in the top left corner, then we can open up a new GUI window. If you want to, you can close this. You can open up here a new GUI window, or you can directly open up a new window with the slash O prefix. We would like to analyze and identify this table in the data browser. So in a transaction code SE16N. And here we can enter the table name VBAK, hit enter, and then we can analyze, do a selection and so on to analyze this one. But here we are basically in a transaction code ME23N to display purchase orders. And here, for example, in the item detail under delivery, there we see some kind of checkboxes. And for example, if we would like to know more about the GR non-evaluated checkbox, then we can set the focus into this checkbox, hit the F1 key on our keyboard, and then again we can open up the technical information. And here we aren't seeing the table that is in use for this checkbox. So if we, for example, copy this one once again, then open the data browser and then pasting this in, then we see that this table is not a table, it has not the correct category. And for example, if we're moving over to the ABAP dictionary in the transaction code SE11, then under data type, there we can enter this, click on display, and then here we see that this is a structure, not a table. So in the next steps, I would like to show you how you can identify and get the table of an input field, even though the F1 help is not showing this. So to stay in an example of the GR non-evaluated checkbox in a purchase order in a transaction code ME23N, we can also use a where use list. And so again, we set the focus into this checkbox, hit the F1 key on our keyboard, click on the technical information button, and then we are seeing right here that under the table name, so in this case it's a structure, and there we can see the field name and the data element that is in use. So here we can double click on the data element onto this field by using the forward navigation. So I double click on this one, then we're basically jumping into the ABAP dictionary in the transaction code SE11. And here in the button bar there, we can click on the where used list, or you could also use the key combination Control Shift and F3. And here it's important that you select table fields because we want to get know where this field is in use in different tables. So to identify the used table, then we click on this execute button, or you could also hit the enter key on your keyboard. And then right here, you are seeing all the tables that use this data element. And here basically we are seeing that in our case the purchase document item table is in use, the ECPO, and here you can do with double click jump directly into this table and analyze the fields. And to stay in the example of this field, I'm going a couple of steps back by hitting this back button once again and once more. And then we can see here that this structure is in use. So I double click on the structure to go into the ABAP dictionary once again based on the structure. And for this case, so that the structure is in use. So I also can search for this field WEPOS, or I could also use Control F key combination and down here enter it, and then I will also move to this field. Then I double click on the component type, and here we are again in the data element, and I can also do the where used list, select table fields, and then once again under ECPO, there I have exactly the same procedure and entry as we saw earlier. What you also can do is you can use the repository info system. So to use this, first of all, you can open up the transaction code SE84, or if you want to, you can also use SE15. In my case, I'm using SE84. And then this repository information system will open up. What you also can do is you can open the object navigator with the transaction code SE80. And down here, you see the repository information system button. If this button is not available for you, then you can activate it under utilities and settings. And then you can click on the button repository information system. And once you've clicked on this one, that it moves over to this dark yellow, then you can click on this transfer button to also use this repository information system button. And down there under repository information system, then ABAP dictionary, then fields, and table fields. So with double click, you can open up the search, and then in field name, there you can enter WEPOS as the field name is. And then you can execute the selection, and then you will also get this nice result, this nice list. And for example, in our case, we are seeing what kind of tables are using this data element. And if we're scrolling down a little bit, then we're also seeing that the ECPO is listed in here. And with double click, we can also show the transparent table. What you also can do is open up the data browser and the transaction code SE16N. And if you want to, you can also use SE16 or SE16H. In my case, I prefer SE16N. And down here, you can use the important database table DD03L. The DD03L is a table that contains information about table fields. And down here, you can also search for a key field, for example, for the data element, for WEPOS, hit F8 key. And then down here, you will see a nice result of the WEPOS where it is used in different tables. But basically, I would prefer the previous shown steps because this is not that intuitive and you don't have a description or something like this. So use the previous shown tips. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this video and know how to find a table with the F1 help for an input field. Hit the like button, add a comment, and subscribe for free, and then see you in the next video.